best qualities are our greatest wealth.
Follow the guidance of the Holy Quran by shining all evil and following Islam.
Obey your parents and give them due respect. Be a perfect model to your kids and morally correct.
Help your kids and always be.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiruh. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah رب العالمين and I testify that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. It's my pleasure to welcome you all to this new episode concerning family issues. And we're still talking about, this is continuation to what we discussed before about importance of marriage and how Islam view marriage and how something is considered as a means of obeying Allah, worshiping Allah. The same way that you pray to Allah, you fast to Allah, also with the good intention, now your marriage will be a form of ibadah. And as we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Oh, you believe, save yourself as well as your family from your hellfire. So you don't have a family unless you are married. You don't have a children unless you are married. Because Islam, it doesn't acknowledge any relationship between a man and a woman without a marriage. So your children comes as a result of marriage. And your duty as a father or as a mother is to protect your family, to safeguard them from hellfire. So Islam view marriage in respect to the family to be a part of ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see by getting married, we are practicing the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he said, حبب إلي من دنياكم النساء والطيب وجعلت قرة عيني في صلى الله عليه وسلم. It been made dearer to me. It been made dear to me from your dunya, all this material thing and all these things. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, something been made dear to him is what? Perfume, marrying women, but look now what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seen. وَجُعَلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been made dear to him. Women to get married, perfume, and the total satisfaction of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in what? In the salah. Now let's look by when you getting married, you are doing the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And look how the Prophet had been made dear to me, because he's a human being. He's still the messenger of Allah, but he's a human being. So there is needs, there is desires, there is wants, and the Prophet fulfilling it through the marriage. But look, the Prophet also talking about the perfume. For a Muslim to understand, to smell good, to look good, and the relationship also between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, between you and the public, that you're smelling good, and also the way how you present yourself to your wife. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the things that he likes is what? Is perfume. But it's very important to see how this hadith is ending. Say, وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. So the perfume and the women, the marriage, all these things, is still only a way for a human being needs and wants. But the perfection, the total satisfaction, the coolness of the eyes, you can see a total fulfillment in what? In the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is in Salah. And we want, although that is not related to marriage immediately, but it's very important to understand the same way that we think about our wives, that we want to be with them, with our husband, we want to dwell to them and the other things. Your relationship with Allah, your relationship with Allah in Salah. And this, it shows you, it is very important for a Muslim to understand about this personal relationship. Because you always Christian telling you, your religion, don't. There is no a personal relationship. No, we have a personal relationship. To such a degree that the Prophet is showing that the total satisfaction, contentment in Salah, not in marriage, not in intimate relationship, not in perfume, but in what? Being between Allah's hands, calling in Allah, making salah. This is something very important. Look, the Hadith al-Qudsi, when he talks about قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ. Allah Almighty is saying in the Hadith al-Qudsi, what the meaning is, I divided the prayer to two halves. I divide the prayer between me and my slave servant. So there is a portion for you, and there is a portion for Allah. So when you say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah say, Hamadani Abdi, my slave servant has praised me. So don't recite Quran like I understand, try to do any kind of prayer. But enjoy the relationship with Allah Almighty. Try to feel that Allah is talking to you, that you're saying, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Try to think about the gifts and the blessings that Allah shower you with it. And to try as if you listen, you're hearing Allah is saying that my slave servant had praised me. So some people, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Ghayr Maghdub, Alayhim, Wala Dhalin, Ameen, Allahu Akbar. No, this not the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. كَانَ يَقِفُ عِنْدَ رَأْسِ كُلِّ آيَةٍ. He used to stop after every verse. He used to taste. He used to have a feeling. He used to have a desire for the salah. To such a degree, it became what? The full and the complete satisfaction. وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So as also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that this is the sunnah, not only of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the prophets before, all the prophets that got married, although with the exception of Isa alayhi salam, okay? But he did not do it for a purpose of a devotion to be more closer to Allah, like some of the Sufi people or some of the monks, they do it. This is not correct. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us that, O Muhammad, we had sent the prophets and messenger before you, وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَذُرِّيَّةً وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولِنَا أَنْ يَأْتِيَ بِآيَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Indeed, we had sent messengers and prophets before you, and we made wives for them, and what? وَذُرِّيَّةً, sons, grandchildren. There is nothing wrong or shame for somebody to be married. There's nothing wrong or shame for somebody to have intimate relationship. But what is sin? What is wrong to have it with the wrong partner or have it out of Al-Islam? So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for instituting the institution of marriage. And by viewing Islam and learning about the deen, see how Islam respects the marriage and how Islam view marriage and how Islam make it to be part of your deen, part of the order of Allah, part of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, part of your duty as a Muslim, part of means and ways to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all these things is to encourage us to get married. And all this, it teach us that we encourage us to respect the marriage and to respect the institution of marriage and not to take the marriage as a game or like a fun, like some people marry here today for a couple of months or a year and after this go to another state and after this another marriage and even sometimes no divorce, no khul', and now 5-6 wives is still under his supervision. This is not correct. We have to respect the marriage. Allah is saying, وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْكُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا, and we took from you a very strong and very serious commitment. The relationship between a man and a wife is a mithaq, is a pledge, is a pledge. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call it mithaq, and he described it to be ghalid, is serious. We have to understand about the institution of marriage and how marriage respect, how Islam respects the marriage, and for us to deal with marriage, a form of ibadah, it means to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's go for a short break, inshallah. Stay tuned. We'll be back right away. Thank you for watching.
Allah has blessed us with youth and good health.
If you're 18 or if you're 80, if you've been Muslim for 50 years or 5 minutes, this is a show for you. You know, when 5 times a day our foreheads touch the ground in prayer, we beg for what's most important in our lives. We want to be good people, better Muslims. We want to serve Allah Almighty with all our hearts. In this show, Let's Talk, every week we're going to talk about Islam and life, how to relate with other people and how to serve Allah. We'll have studio guests, we'll have a live studio audience. There'll be an email for you to write to, talk@huda.tv. So if you're looking for something different, looking for something that will make you think, maybe even touch your heart, this is the show for you.
Allah has blessed us with youth and good health.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah. Welcome back. We're still talking about marriage in Islam, and this related to family issues. And we have a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he reported by Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her. جاء ثلاثة رهط إلى بيوت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يسألون عن عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلما أخبروا بها كأنهم تقالوها وقالوا أين نحن من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Three of the companions came to the house of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asking Mother Aisha, mother of the believers, may Allah be pleased with her, how is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم worshiping Allah? She told them, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he make tahajjud part of the night, qiyam al-layl, sleep other part of the night. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fast, optional fasting some days, and a breakfast. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he have a relationship with his wives. But when they heard this, they felt like this is not enough for them, and say, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been forgiven by Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah had forgive his past and future sins. But for us, we are not. We are not being forgiven. We don't know if we are forgiven. So every one of them made a commitment, made intention. With good intention, they made this commitment. And one of them said, "Amma ana fa asum ad-dahr." As for me, I will fast the whole year. Every day I will fast. You want to get more closer to Allah. The other person said, وَأَنَا أَقُومُ اللَّيْلِ, as for me, no sleeping. And the third one, he said, what? وَأَنَا أَعْتَزِلُ النِّسَاءِ. The third one, he said, I'm not going to marry. I'm not going to get married. And if he's going to be, if he's married, he's going to stay away from his wife. Now, why those Sahaba made this intention and made this commitment? Because with good intentions, they want to get closer to Allah. They want Allah to be more pleased with them. So they left. فَلَمَّا رَجَعَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ أُخْبِرَ بِخَبَرِ الْقَوْمِ. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came back, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, told him that such a thing happened. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was not pleased with this report. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went outside and أمر بلال أن ينادى بالصلاة, and he called the adhan. The Muslims, he came, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم started to address his community. Wallahi, إني لأعلمكم بالله وأخشاكم لله. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, by Allah, I know about Allah more than anyone of you. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anyone of you. But أنام وأقوم الليل, أصوم وأفطر, وأتزوج النساء, فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I know about Allah more than anyone of you. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anyone of you. But with this fear, with this taqwa, what I do? I sleep some of the night. I break fast some of the days. In addition to this, I have a relationship with my wives and I marry women. Now, whosoever turn away or object my sunnah, my way of living, my way of worshiping and getting closer to Allah, فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي, he's not part of my nation. So now we can see the problem of some people who assuming by staying away from their wives, this will bring more closer to Allah. Or staying away from marriage, they can be more closer to Allah. Like some of the Sufis, they do this. And even in other religions, like some, what they call them, sisters and nuns and the sea. But in reality, like I said, you could not fight something. You could not conquer something that Allah make it inside you. Allah makes this inclination of a man to a woman and a woman to a man is there inside us. You could not fight your needs for eating, drinking, sleeping. If you could not do this, how are you going to fight something which is more stronger than food, which is a sexual desire? You could not. And those people who turn to be monks and sisters and devote themselves to Allah, they deceive their own selves. They could not keep this kind of commitment. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَرَهْبَانِيَّةٍ ابْتَدَعُوهَا مَا كَتَبْنَاهَا عَلَيْهَا مَا كَتَبْنَاهَا عَلَيْهِمْ. And this kind of rahbaniyah, so much devotion to Allah by making things which halal, haram in their own self to get closer to Allah, فَمَا رَعَوْهَا حَقَّ رَعَايَتَ. They could not keep this kind of, why? Because they're fighting. So we see that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in this hadith, he said that part of his ibadah, part of fearing Allah, part of being devoted to Allah, وأتزوج النساء, I get married to women. And he found this to be one of deviation from the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he said, فَمَنْ رَغِبَ عَنْ سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. Subhanallah. See the beauty of Islam. And later on we found that Islam even telling us, وَفِي بِضْعِي أَحَدِكُمْ صَدَقَةً. One of you having intercourse with his wife will be a charity for you. I'm sure that some of you, as soon as they hear this, they say, oh, this is good. Let me have more blessing. So go ahead. Get blessings. And the Sahaba was surprised. He said, oh, Prophet of Allah, how one of us will fulfill his own desires and get reward and get a blessings? He say, what about if he put it in haram? What about if he have a wrong relationship? A lawful relationship, a man with a man, or a woman with a woman, or a man with animals, or a man with a child, all the things which is haram, boyfriend, girlfriend, alayhi wizr, if he be committing sin, is going to be recorded against him, if he bought this in haram, source, said yes. He said, so if he bought it in the right source, will be a blessing for him. What else he can, where else he can find a relationship between you and your Creator? Part of it is fulfilling your desire. So let's be grateful. Let's be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the institution of marriage in Islam. And it's not this only. He told you, فَانْكِحُوا مَا طَابَ لَكُم مِّنَ النِّسَاءِ مَثْنَا وَثُلَاثَ وَرُبَاعَ. With the condition, we talk about it later, فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا. Marry what you desire from women. 2, 3, and 4. But if you fear unjust, being unfair, so stick to one. Let's see with this story that we're going to try to see how Islam also continued to emphasize the issue of marriage, respecting marriage, adoring marriage, and making marriage to be part of your deen and part of your religion. أخى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بين سلمان الفارسي وأبو الدرداء. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, with the migration of the Muhajirin from Mecca and the Ansar of the Medina, he made establish a brotherhood. You with so and so, you family so and so, with family so and so. So he established this brotherhood among the Muhajirin and Ansar. So Abu Darda, may Allah be pleased with him, his partnership or his brotherhood ship came with who? With Salman al-Farisi. So Salman visited the house of Abu Darda. But when he reached there, he found his wife in a ragged clothes. So he was surprised. He asked her, what's wrong? She's supposed to be a married woman, present herself in proper way. Okay? So he asked, what's wrong? She told him, أخوك أبو الدرداء ليس له حاجة في النساء. Your brother of Abu Darda, he doesn't care about wife. He's there about salah, prayer, fasting, dhikr, all these things. Salman al-Farisi, he said, okay. He waited. He waited until about Abu Darda came, and after this, food and ma'ida, he say, eat. He say, I'm fasting. Salman say, eat. He say, I'm fasting. He said, if you don't eat, I'm not going to eat. So Abu Darda have to break his fast. Okay? And after this, he ate with him. Now when the night fall, now Abu Darda, he's want to make Qiyam al-Layl. Salman say, sleep. What's going on? Say, sleep. He say, no. Finally, he making a complete change in life of Abu Darda. And after this, he told him what? Inna li rabbika alayka haqqa. Inna li zawjika alayka haqqa. Inna li badanika alayka haqqa. فَعَطِ لِكُلِّ ذِي حَقٍ حَقًّا. Indeed, Allah has a right over you. Your wife has a right over you. And your body have a right over you. Give everyone its right. Alhamdulillah for Islam. Until I see you again, I'm your host, Mohammad Sayed Adli from Columbia, South Carolina. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك. نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. And Allah knows best.
Allah has blessed us with youth and good health. Of these qualities are our greatest wealth.
Follow the guidance of the Holy Quran by shining all evil and following Islam.
Obey your parents and give them due respect. Be a perfect